Good morning, kids. How are you all? Hope you all are doing fine. So, in the last class, we completed our poem, fourth chapter. That was poem, Courage. So, today we will complete our exercises. So, before writing your question answers in the classwork, do write the hard words and the meanings. Then after, write the question and answers. Okay, kids? So, get ready with your readers at page number 33. Okay, fine. So the first one question here is, what reason does the poet give for using crutches? What is the reason? The reason is he was lame. Good. The poet gave lameness as his reason for using crutches. Okay, now next one. What did the physician do with the crutches? Okay, physician unke jo doctor the, what did he do with the crutches? He broke them. The physician broke the crutches and threw them in fire. Hai na? Usko fire mein fek diye. Next, was the poet cured of his lameness completely? Ye jo poet hai, kya wo completely at the final unko treatment hone ke baad, was he cured completely? What will be your answer? Here in the last passage, it's being saying ke, well, I am cured now. I can walk, cured by nothing more than Lord. Sometimes though when I see sticks, I walk worse for some hours after. So in this, it's being saying ke, he was cured of his lameness mentally, but physically he was still lame. Our answer must be, yes, he was cured of his lameness mentally. Unko kya hua, doctor unka utna acha treatment kare just by laughing. Okay, unko itna courage diye ke, he was mentally prepared. He was mentally... He was mentally as in cured. वो बहुत अच्छे हो गए थे mentally. उनके पास इतनी हिम्मत आ गई थी to live. But physically he was still lame. But physically क्या था उनके? He was lame. He was not having one leg. Okay? So we'll send you in the group. From there you can copy. And next bit. Write one or two words for the following. Okay? So, यहाँ पे हमें sentences दिए गए हैं. According to these sentences, we have to pick up the word, correct verb from the help box and write against it. A person who find it difficult to read and spell. A person who find it difficult to read and spell. What is that person called as? So, have you seen that movie Tare Zameen Par? I hope everyone saw that. So, in that small kid is having a problem of not remembering, isn't it? He is having a difficulty to read, write and spell. Hai na? So what is that called as? What is the condition of that boy called as? It is called as dyslexia. Here it is given as dyslexia. So jo kids ko jo likhne ke liye problem hoti hai, padhne ke liye problem hoti hai, those types of kids, the condition of those kids is called as dyslexia. Next one, a person who speaks with difficulty. बहुत अक्सर मोस्टली द किड्स टॉक्स इन अ वेरी स्टैमरिंग लैंग्वेज है ना, बहुत हाफ हाफ बात करते हैं, बहुत छोटे लड़के जो होते हैं स्टैमर करके बात करें, दोज पीपल्स आर कॉल्ड एज स्टैमरर. दे कैन नॉट प्रोनाउंस द वर्ड्स प्रॉपरली, बहुत रुकते रुकते बात करते हैं, जिसको हम हमारी लैंग्वेज में तुतले बोलते हैं. सेम वे दोज किड्स आर कॉल्ड एज स्टैमर, दोज टाइप ऑफ पर्सन आर कॉल्ड एज स्टैमरर. थर्ड वन, अ पर्सन हु इज़ लेस डेवलप्ड मेंटली. बहुत सारे पर्सन होते हैं, दे आर मैनी ह्यूमन बींग्स ऑन दिस अर्थ हु आर मेंटली चैलेंज. ओके, दिस पर्सन आर कॉल्ड एज मेंटली चैलेंज. लाइक दे डोंट नो वॉट दे आर डूइंग, उनका माइंड सही से डेवलप नहीं होता है. सो दोज पीपल आर कॉल्ड एज मेंटली चैलेंज. अ पर्सन विथ फिजिकल डिफेक्ट्स. ओके, जिसके फिजिकल डिफेक्ट्स यानी उनकी जो बॉडी है उसमें बॉडी में किसी के पास फिजिकली डिफेक्ट है, लाइक दे आर हैविंग अ ब्लाइंड आई, दे आर नॉट हैविंग अ लेग, दे आर नॉट हैविंग वन हैंड लाइक आइदर, दे आर नॉट हैविंग द टू लेग्स. सो जो हमें अटायर दिखता है, लाइक वी कैन सी देयर इज अ डिफेक्ट इन द बॉडी, उनकी बॉडी में एक डिफेक्ट है, दे आर नॉट कम्प्लीट. सो वॉट दिस पर्सन आर कॉल्ड एज, दिस पर्सन आर कॉल्ड एज फिजिकली चैलेंज्ड. ओके, नेक्स्ट वन, अ पर्सन हु कैन नॉट सी. मोस्टली हम उसे ब्लाइंड बोलेंगे, बट दे आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज विजुअली चैलेंज. ओके, विजन, जो विजन है वो दिखाई नहीं देता है, आई विजन. सो दीज पीपल आर कॉल्ड एज visually challenged. Okay, so we'll do it again. A person who finds it difficult to read and spell are called dyslexic. A person who speak with difficulty, stammerer. A person who is less developed mentally, mentally challenged. A person who with some difficult defects, he is called physically challenged. A person who cannot see, he is visually challenged. Okay, now come to the next part. In this, the chief guest gave the visually challenged a prize. So we can write it in another way. The chief guest gave a prize to the visually challenged. Okay, we are just changing the sentence. The meaning is same only, but we are changing the sentence. So here, some more sentences are being given. We have to write in the changing the pattern. First one, he offered the lame a good job. Okay, तो हम इसको थोड़ा सा change करके लेंगे. He offered a good job for the lame. My father gave me a phone. Okay, to change write the sentence, how will we write? A phone was given to me by my father. My grandfather told me an interesting story. तो rewrite कैसे करेंगे हम इसको? An interesting story was told by my grandfather. The sheep gives us wool. Rewrite it. We get wool from sheep. She gifted her brother a television. If you rewrite this sentence, it will be the television is a gift from his sister. Okay? The television is a gift from his sister. Okay? Now, he offered the lame a good job. He offered a good job for the lame. Changing the sentence. My father gave me a phone. A phone was given to me by my father. My grandfather told me an interesting story. An interesting story was told by my grandfather. The sheep gives us wool. We get wool from sheep. She gifted her brother a television. The television is a gift from his sister. Okay, kids? Fine. So now come to the next one. Find the place where a word from can be inserted in these sentences. हमें क्या करना है? ये sentence में, all this sentence में, the word from insert करके, we have to again change and write the sentence. So see here for the first one, I can see your face that you are sad. I can see your face that you are sad. I can see your face, you are sad. So इसमें from कहाँ पर we'll insert? I can see from your face that you are sad. मैं आपके चेहरे से बता सकता हूँ that you are sad. So next one, he was getting thin day by day, lack of food. He was getting thin day by day, lack of food. तो यहाँ कहाँ पे आएगा? Insert will insert from after day. So the sentence will be he was getting thin day by day from lack of food. है ना? क्यों thin हो रहे थे day by day? Because of lack of food. So from lack of food. I don't know where she comes. I don't know where she comes from. We'll write from at the end of the sentence. After that, full stop. I don't know where she comes from. Next one. He was tired out working all night. He was tired out working all night. So what we'll write? He was tired out from working all night. Yeah. After out, we'll add from. Next. It was about 2 kilometers my house. How will we insert the word from? It was about 2 kilometers my house. So after kilometer, if we insert from, the sentence will be it was about 2 kilometers from my house. He was out of breath running for the bus. He was out of breath running for the bus. Where should we insert from? After was. He was from out of breath running for the bus. Okay, kids? So we'll send this in the group. From there you can copy. And below that you have to write 2 nouns that have the following endings. Aapko kya karna hai? You have to write 2 nouns. Okay? Jiski ending hoti hai same letters. Okay? Like beauty, kindness. The ending is kindness. So here in the first one, it's a misspell. You have to write the word ending with ty. Okay? So here there is a misprint. In this, you have to write the ending with ty. Okay? लाइक ब्यूटी NESS, काइंडनेस MENT, एन्जॉयमेंट TION, मोशन. ओके, ये वर्ड्स की जो एंडिंग आती है वो वर्ड्स आपको यहाँ पे यू हैव टू राइट द नाउंस. ओके, सो दिस इज विल बी योर होमवर्क इन द रीडर. एंड फॉर योर क्लास वर्क यू हैव टू कंप्लीट द क्लास वर्क विद फिल इन द मीनिंग्स एंड हार्ड वर्ड्स. रीड अप पेजेस 34, बी बिट एंड कंप्लीट योर क्लास वर्क. Fine kids, so we'll meet in our next class. Till then, stay home, stay safe, and don't trouble your parents.